By then you'd get more hungry. And let us make this very informal session. I don't want to make it very formal.
So would you all want to get your photograph clicked exclusively? Mm-hmm. Please come over.
So I'm going to, well, let's make it very informal and very interactive and not very formal. That I'll ask because, is there any prize for the best answer? That's what we have been asked.
No, but definitely. But best, the definition of best resides, the power to decide that resides with me, right? So the funniest, wackiest answer will be declared as the best answer.
So everybody
has to
give outrageous answers. And which can really impress Vika. So are we ready?
Yes, ready.
So whoever, do we have another mic? Yeah, I have a mic. Okay. So maybe, and this first question that I want to come up with. What are the top 3 challenges faced by chief security officers, and how does your organization define, and in a mobile enterprise mobility situation, enterprise mobility strategy, what are the top 3 challenges you face, and how does your top management?
I can tell you the top 3 security challenges faced by our CISO.
In the enterprise mobility.
I'm giving you in general. It is the CEO, CFO, and CEO.
Good answer. It may be noted.
So this is definitely in the list of best answers.
So others? If you don't answer, I think the partners will take the credit. They will answer and take the
credit. Oh, this is CSO versus partner competition.
Don't give that chance to the partners. Come up with 3 top challenges in the enterprise mobility question. No one has deployed.
Okay, one. Let's start with one challenge. One biggest challenge, according to you. Enterprise mobility.
in the enterprise mobility case, like the biggest challenge is what kind of application we have to expose to the user. That's the biggest challenge. Every application, the enterprise application, has a customer confidential information. Whenever you are exposing on a mobile, so it basically towards you are opening that more vulnerable, right? So that's one of the organization threat, like everyone has.
Does everybody agree with Kapil that the biggest challenge is which application to expose?
But it's not what we
have said about this. No, it may not always be package, but this is the biggest. So we have to
give more realistic. More realistic challenge.
I think manageability of different platforms, you know, the variety of platforms, because, you know, the mobility is so much consumerized that it is actually driven by the user what device he is bringing. And supporting that device with the enterprise applications, you know, various devices is also important.
So platform proliferation, that's the biggest challenge. Okay. Does everybody agree? So we've got 2. Platform proliferation, we've got what application to allow and how much data. What other challenges there? When it comes to mobility, for you as a CISO. CIOs are also allowed to answer. So Mukesh ji, you cannot escape. What is the biggest challenge when it comes to mobility for a CIO or a CSO? The biggest challenge. So I think we... Two alternatives that have been... Yeah. Go ahead.
I'm giving you a very genuine challenge which happens. So when you develop any application for mobility, when you host it and you have to do this testing, the DNS replicates after 48 hours. So within 24 hours, if you want to do a testing and then release this product for the client to do his integration testing, you are not able to do that unless you are doing all the proxy bypasses and then reviewing it. And then only you can give it to the client. This is a genuine issue which is faced by all mobile applications.
Well, in good terms, I say like segregating professional and personal content, but I'll put it like this: ensuring that your wife's shopping list is not mixed up with your to-do list of the day.
Okay. Good point. So, note kiya jaye. Acha answer hai.
So, any other? Now, if you don't have any other challenges, I would like to ask: so, what is the best solution you could suggest for these? Anyone? Best
solution? Best practice that you have been adopting, practicing
within your organization. Don't allow mobility. That is not part of the trend, right? So you need to be part of the trend. So all your mobiles, please
don't.
Give it to me. So, no solution? Yeah.
Mobility is a costly affair. Whenever we are planning to solutionize anything, so we have to work on some equation, right? Let's say a company has a 25,000 employees and he wants to distribute 5,000 tablets or iPads. That's very costly. So what they have to do is, whatever they want to roll out, they have to roll out. That's one. Second thing is, they have to identify the potential users, right, which can really generate the ROI faster, right, like Salesforce. So they are the fastest guy in the organization, they can turn down. Let's say you have around 200 people in the sales group. Phase one comes to sales group. And then gradually you are basically one from the feedback experience, more experience, then you can roll up. That's what is my thing. This is what is my organization. We have identified the community, we have identified the applications, we have rolled out. Gradually we are going to the least.
So how much time did it take to get this?
Let's say the phase one we have closed for the 6 months. 6 months is going to complete in March.
So then who all did you involve in this?
Bank of Bank. And we are targeting 2,000 people for this.
But that still would represent
60 people face covered, we are covering 60 people.
But will there ever be
100%
Yes, of course. Any
other solution? Yes, it's open for
everyone, open forum. So, mobility is really a big concern nowadays, like people, when they talk about like bringing their own device to office. So hi, my name is Ankur and I'm from academic. So they need to meet approach. And we say today, are you using laptops in your network? Everyone is using laptops. How do you see your laptop? Are they not a mobile device?
So current partner is not allowed. People are traveling
to laptops. The laptops are lost. So when you talk about mobile devices, what are the pain areas? What are the problem questions?
First thing, when laptops came to your network, you said that giving your corporate data on a laptop, user take the data from the copies to a pen drive. How do you handle that? So in McAfee, Hilton, we say that you have to first see the picture. And we see the way you see your laptops today. Same approach needs to be extended for your mobile devices. The way you make policies for your laptops, for data should be secure, for authentication, for giving applications on your mobile device, on your laptops. Same approach needs to be transferred on mobile devices. So first thing, the biggest challenge which we see is the provisioning of mobile devices. So how company, if a new employee comes in and says that I need a mobile device, I need mobile applications there. So how would you provision that mobile device to your mobile management solution? So that is the first process. Then what application you want to give to that user? Is it mail or something else? There need to be some solution in that mobile device. The once mobile device is enrolled to your organization, you should have some predefined tabs over there. That when that those tabs, you just enroll the mobile device, clicking on that corporate apps, you can see those apps. Biggest challenge, the customer comes in the office, they say that we need to configure our mobile devices to get internet access. So every time IT guy has to go down to his mobile device, access is wireless, username and password. But today, the mobile management solutions are pretty mature. On the single centralized console, without any interference of the end user, the provision those devices. So you can give, you can host your solution publicly in public network. You can go to App Store, can download the app. You just need to authenticate. And just with authentication of that specific application, is provisioned to you. Then you can give him the apps based on his, like he's a finance user, what apps could be given to the finance user. Then there's one more thing which is very common now is, how do you keep the data, personal data and official data in two separate things? There are some containers which comes in. So,
An extension to what Rajiv said, so you have a biggest challenge, CIO, right? So maybe Suresh would like to add something as a follow-up to that.
When you talk about the C-level being the challenge, right, what exactly does that mean? Is it the ability to go build a business case? Is it the lack of any opportunity that you're having? What exactly does that mean?
I thought I'll just pass a joke and then it will be a icebreaker and everyone will start. But it has become a question more.
Okay, basically CFO, it's very difficult to convince him to do any expenditure. And from operations point of view, I mean, they just want to do anything, without any security aspects. And CEO basically is only concerned whether we have some major security breach or something. That's all, if nothing of a security breach is there, then everything is fine. So that's why I said CEO, CFO and CEO. When I was asked what are the three major challenges.
So if you look at, and this is probably it.
So I think we all know that your security is as strong as the weakest link in the whole setup. And you know, all these three guys will, you know, go out in market on an international airport, bring a device which is not compatible and they want to get integrated. They don't really understand. That I think is another serious
problem. Okay. Now, who do you believe is like an influencer in this, right? If you've got to go back and convince somebody in your organization that there is a significant business benefit by adopting mobile, right? Where would you be? Would you try to approach somebody in, you know, marketing? Would it be a line of business? What exactly is the resistance coming from? For example, if you take banking, right? There are obvious benefits to mobile banking, right? You look at retail, benefits to, you know, having mobile banking in the retail industry as well. But if you look at it purely from a security perspective, you find it hard to build a business case. Right? Because you're always protecting. I want more money because I want to keep myself safe. It doesn't sound right. Right? So if you want to take a slightly different approach, what is it that will help you? Is it revenue drive? that a convincing enough story to go back to somebody and see them and say, yes sir, you spend so much, but I get 3x.
So, coming to the next question, all of you, I want everyone to pay attention to this question.
Hello, one of the challenges that I think about the mobility would be the data loss and theft associated with it, and the recovery and the cost that would be involved.
You all agree with that? All of you? That's interesting. So the next question I will throw up. Okay. What are the key challenges that you all face, the key challenges that you all face in aligning with business, in aligning security with business requirement, and which also, besides aligning with business requirements, how do you ensure that your business objectives and goals are met? The challenges in front of you, how do you align with business requirements and help them meet their objectives? The first, I think, maybe is how does business perceive you? You're a policeman, or an instructor, or you're a supporter. So what are the challenges you face while meeting business objectives and requirements? Anyone? No challenge at all?
Business perceives it as necessary evil. You know, you talk to them, they say it's a problem, and you end up signing a piece of paper to say everything is secure, while you know for sure it is not. So it's like a necessary evil. There is no, it's not seen. It's a cost for sure. It's a cost for sure, but you have to incur it. It's not seen it positively.
Cost is one aspect of it. But besides that, as a security, the first challenge that you face when you want to initiate a project with business. So what is that I would like to know? Or maybe all your friends would like to know. Any other? So any of you would like to answer the business challenge that security says face? While meeting business objectives, any solution that you would suggest? Any of you?
The important thing is to make them understand that what is the importance of security and make them aware that it is not going to harm their business, it may help them in securing the environment.
Today, in fact, I have been speaking to a lot of participants in the morning, and we have had a lot of interviews. I got very nice answers, very, very interesting answers on best strategies or best security practices or best approaches to align with business. But I don't know why everyone is silent now. You're not on the video anymore. You're too tired. I think you are now in the fast.
Geeta, I can give you a wacky answer if you want.
Absolutely.
Geeta? Geeta? Geeta?
Behind.
I can give you a wacky answer to this. Okay. So if you agree to the business guy, you become a hero.
Okay.
If you partially agree, you are a side hero. And if you don't agree, you are a villain. So that's the role we play.
So which one do you prefer to be?
I generally prefer to be the villain.
So so nice. That's a good boss, being a good boss. So any other perspective? Everyone seems to be aligning very well with business. They don't have a challenge.
No challenge, that means everybody is getting funded sufficiently.
Sufficiently. So we can conduct more CISO forums. Right?
So finally, the question to the others.
Yes.
And
they have great opportunities. All the partners have great opportunities. Any other perspective anyone wants to add?
Ye photo le li. Ha le le.
The gentleman over there said that we are coming out with some security source or proposal which has to be passed. I think we will have to translate that into a non-technical language to the non-technical people sitting on top so that they get to see the benefits coming out. And then, give us the
do you all agree with that? How many agree? Raise your hands.
I think the success depends on how we convert the technicalities into a non-technicality so that a non-technical person understands the importance. And
so you essentially speak the business language when they come out.
The strategy part.
Yeah. Thank you. So,
what if there is a business project, the business the market opportunity is only there. They want you to launch a solution. They are very keen to launch a solution for the business. You have looked at the solution, you think it's not secure enough, or there seems to be high risk. How do you handle the solution? Business wants to do it. You are all very aligned to the business, you think we should support the business. But how are you going to solve this kind of problem?
Hello?
Because this will happen, you know, as today Philip said, you know, all the speakers said, the business is changing so fast, the requirements will come out. Not in a planned way, you won't have 6 months, you won't have 12 months to deploy. You have to deploy almost immediately. Whether it is e-commerce or any such initiative. How would you handle such a situation? In terms of balancing the risk versus the gain.
I think this happens more often these days. You know, there is more than IT solutions which are sourced by IT is actually being sourced by users and marketing people. And that is all to support one single cause, which is growth of business. So, you know, I think what we need, like he said that, you know, we need to align people who are decision makers, make them understand that, you know, what are these security risks and provide a solution around it to ensure that, you know, that the cause is taken forward rather than doing a policeman role that, you know, stop it because of the security risk associated with it. Because at the end of the day, the goal of business is traditionally what we have been doing is we have been stopping it because don't go to cloud because of the security risk associated. So I think we have to slightly change the role, educate people at every level, and then along with that as a steering committee take decisions.
That is a big challenge. You know, it's all very well trying to align people. By the time you get the meeting, you explain, they figure out. They say this is all taking too long.
So,
common push back to the business head with me, this is all taking very long. Why can't we have it tomorrow?
Absolutely. So that is where the education part should, you know, happen more frequently. You should have a proper steering committee who should educate with or without any requirement in hand, so that, you know, people are ready for that situation. Before you start speaking about security, they should ask those preliminary questions. Is it secure? Where the data is going to reside? What about customer privacy and all of that? Instead of you asking that, the moment they start talking your language, I think the battle is already won.
But other people agree. I mean, some people here are sitting very quiet, so they're not participating. So we're not going to let you sit quiet. You're not supposed to give a view on this, is it? So I think the question there is, you know, so how are you going to help them do this? Okay.
So maybe this last question, which...
So in my view, I think that's the reason why it is very important for the CISO to be part of the organization's strategy in the first place. They should be aware of what the organization is looking at from a business perspective, where they're going to go, so that proactively the CISO can also start working on various steps, various controls and various measures, which, you know, the clients may ask. So if he's involved in the strategy, then only there's a possibility that, you know, this speed can be achieved.
Okay, and the last question.
Thank you.
Before you all get really busy with your and get hungry. So, this is a very sensitive question, probably you all be discussing about cost. So, is there a way or is there a pattern that you measure security practices within your organization? The best security, how is it? Do you have a metrics to measure? Anyone? That would really help others, your friends, maybe emulate a kind of best practice. How do you? Is there a methodology that you follow? Anyone? Anyone can speak about it? Any metrics?
So, I metrics as to the effectiveness of security,
yes,
or
how do you measure
ROI
security? Security practice is best, or it is a model which will be really worked out.
There's no ROI on security. So, there's one honest admission, there's no ROI on security.
So, you cannot quantify security? Like, you have ROI for everything, right?
ROI for everything.
Why not?
For security, there is no ROI. See, how can you measure a security? The purpose of putting the security is for the incident not to occur. And if the incident has not occurred, we'll find the value in it. You can find only the value when there is no security in the incident occurs. So how can you create an ROI? There is no ROI. There is no way an ROI.
So there is a tangible and intangible, right? ROI is a strategy. So when the security occurs, when there is a fraud, then there is a huge loss. There is a loss. So it's a reputation from so many tangible, intangible. So is there a way to suggest?
I don't agree that ROI is not attached to security. Why? How can you make a big deployment unless you don't justify the statements there? Yes, definitely incident management does count. To avoid incident management, there are concepts like balance scorecards that get introduced at every level. To meet the service operations, to meet the availability or an uptime of management, applications, networks, we talk about, and which also has a financial clause added to it. So I think so, metrics in terms of uptime, information security are the key metrics which definitely justify ROI. Especially I'm talking from the telecom world, because where I used to be there earlier. So that was one of the key parameters.
Thank you. Anyone else who agree or disagree?
So the other way to measure the ROI, instead of the ROI, what we, the other way of measurement is probably value at risk. The way we measure financial risk, the way we measure operational risk. If you look at the bank's operational risk, there's a very well-defined framework for measurement of operational risk. And information security is also a part of the operational risk framework. So if you measure value at risk, I think that is one way of showing the measurement.
Value at risk.
question.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Any partners who would like to add something? Partners would like to add some insights on how to measure. You must be helping your customers, right? In measuring security.
Value of security. How do you
measure
value of security?
Value of security.
Your
thoughts? I just want to ask
maybe
one question.
I should walk around in the back and ask you. Right? How do you measure value of security?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
The best solution will get it right. Giri, should we say the best solution will get a prize? Should
yes.
we say the best solution
yeah.
in the measuring metrics value of will get
yes.
a prize?
Yes.
Yes.
So, who can come up with the best way to measure the value of security? Everybody has to agree that that's the best way. So, I think he's already suggested value at risk. So, that's one way to measure the value of security. Who else wants to propose another way? Otherwise, we'll give him the prize.
Yes. When it comes.
I'm not going to tell about any solution, but we are planning to act. And by act, we will showcase you the solution. Yeah.
Okay, good. So, competition.
Sit back and relax. Everybody sit back and relax.
Sit back, relax, and so that you enjoy the flight.